We are live at the Spectrum in Philadelphia, where tonight the Buffalo Bandits go after the Philadelphia Wings. It's the battle for the World Championship, live on Prime and the Empire Sports Network.
A lot of people, when they say new franchises, they say, well, 3, 4, 5 years down the road. We're going after it the first year, and I think we've got enough talent over there to do it all the way for the Bandits. Thanks a lot.
It was a statement made in October of 1991, but one made true in the early months of 1992. The high-scoring Buffalo Bandits went from a dismal 0-3 to a fantastic 5-3. A win over the defending champion Detroit Turbos put the new guys on the block into the final. World championships have been won by a charter franchise, the Philadelphia Wings. And a man who has led them to those titles plays his final game tonight. The Philly legend, John Tucker, will try to give the Wings their third title in 4 years. Defensively, a man named Dallas will try to stop Buffalo from making a championship run. It's the battle for the North American Cup, next on Prime Network. The Major Indoor Lacrosse League. It's the battle for the World Championship as the Buffalo Bandits take on the Philadelphia Wings. A near sellout crowd is expected at the Spectrum tonight for the Major Indoor Lacrosse League World Championship game. Hello everyone, I'm Craig Johnson, joined by Leif Elsmo, and it didn't seem like that long ago when we were talking about an expansion team, the Buffalo Bandits, having their problems at 0-3.
Well, they were 0-3. They learned to play in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. They learned very well. They're led by a lot of Canadians, and they've gotten here on a lot of Canadian firepower. This team is loaded with offense. Let's take a look at some of the heroes that got them here. Darris Kilgour really loaded the offensive boards coming into the playoffs. 5 goals, 8 assists in the postseason. Kilgour, a big factor offensively. But I think the best player on the field tonight is John Tavares. Look at this. 8 goals, 11 assists, 19 points. That's just a postseason playoff. The thing I like about Tavares is he's got great ground ball stats. He does it all. He plays defense, offense, gets the ground balls, can feed, and can also score.
Going for their third world championship in 4 years, the Philadelphia Wings, and they always seem to do it behind one man, John Tucker.
A lot of pressure on John Tucker tonight. This is his last game. This guy has done it all. He's played for a couple world teams in the United States. He's their leader. Make no bones about it. He's got to do it tonight. He knows it. He got injured in New York. He's playing tonight. He says he's 100%. 6 goals, 5 assists in the playoff postseason here. He's backed up by a nice left-handed shooter, John Nostrin. Now, these two guys, the lefty-righty combination, will really be counted on by Dave Evans to score tonight.
If there's anybody that's nervous going into this game, it may be the two goalkeepers.
Well, they're going to get a lot of pressure because both these teams are going to shoot and shoot a lot. But, you know, championships are won by defense, and this is where the defense starts. It starts in the goal. Let's take a look at these goalkeepers, starting with Dallas Elliott. He is the guy that has kept the scores low, and that allowed Philadelphia, with their low-scoring offense, to get to this championship game. Now, Gerrie came in about the third game of the season, right when they were having trouble, 0-3, maybe the fourth game. He replaced Cowie. Since then, they have been on a roll in the postseason, 78 saves. He was sensational. The Coors Light MVP in the Detroit playoff game, another big reason why they are here, the goalkeeper, Gerrie.
Each team is so different. You think about the Wings on the defense and the high-scoring offense of the Buffalo Bandits. Let's take a look at each team's strength.
All right, this is how they stack up, in my estimation. Off offense, I got to give an edge to Buffalo. They have outshot, outscored everybody in the league by big margins, an average of 10 goals a game the last seven games. Defense, give that edge to Philadelphia. Goalie play also to Philadelphia. Metke is back, by the way, backing up Dallas Elliott. Metke took them to two championships. Power play goes to Buffalo. Depth also to Buffalo. They've got a tremendous depth and health. They are all healthy. Philadelphia banged up, especially John Tucker, and experience. I've got to give that to Philadelphia because they've been to the championship game. Of course, Buffalo's an expansion team. They've got a banner up here the Wings do that has 2 years on it, 89 and 90.
This is what all the players have been playing for since the season began. The World Championship game coming up. We've got the starting lineups in the faceoff when we return to the Spectrum in Philadelphia after this.
Tonight's Major Indoor Lacrosse League Game of the Week is brought to you by Coors Light. It's the right beer now. By U.S. Air. U.S. Air begins with you. By Reebok. Life is short. Play hard. By STX Lacrosse Equipment. And by General Motors. GM is putting quality on the road.
At the Philadelphia Spectrum for the Major Indoor Lacrosse League's battle for the World Championship.
Well, it's an overused expression. It doesn't get any better than this, but it really doesn't. You've got a Canadian-laden team from Buffalo coming down here. All stars from Canada there. Alexander, the great stars of the 70s and the 80s. Tavares, the star of the 90s. And then the great team from Philadelphia, loaded with American stars. Here are the starting lineups. Philadelphia starts this lineup and all the first quarter face-off situations because that's a good defensive lineup for Buffalo. Kilgour, Tavares, May, Maher, Holtz, Bissell, and Gerrie. Now that's a normal run, a normal lineup that you'll see run together. But for Philadelphia, you'll see those guys at the beginning of each quarter because they are a defensive lineup and Dave Evans doesn't want to give up an easy goal up front. Let's take a look at the team comparisons. Statistically, as we look at these two teams, the first thing that jumps off the page at you is the scoring. Look at the goals. Buffalo, 20 goals a game against Philadelphia's 13. Go down to defensive points allowed, and that's where they have a chance. Philadelphia a little stingier, 13.6 and 15.6 for Buffalo. On goal shooting, you can see the offensive numbers all for Buffalo, and that is a big key. Penalty minutes, Buffalo there may be hurting themselves. They tend to spend a lot of time in the penalty box. They've gotten better at that, but that could kill them against Philadelphia. He has been sensational.
I was about to say all the fans back in Buffalo love saying Gerrie every time he makes a big play, but he's done quite well for them all season long.
We mentioned Coors Light MVP last week in Detroit to get him into this championship game. He has come up big when he's had to, and they have been riding his back defensively. They've tightened the defense, and Gerrie's been a big part of that. Now Dallas Elliott, took it down on the goal there. Martin, a good defensive player for Dave Evans, comes over, gives him a little smash in the head, a little crash to get him moving. Elliott's a real big-time stopper. And again, you have to when your offense doesn't score many goals. Elliott really is going to face the most dynamic offense he's ever faced. Buffalo scores in big numbers.
Right for the opening face-off along the near board. And the Wings come away with it with Chris Flint.
Now, John, I would expect that Philadelphia might even get the lead in the first quarter. They're fired up, the crowd's behind them, and they are ready to play. They feel like they're underdogs, and they want to score.
Gonna come out, get score!
Flynn comes in, feeds the middle, coming right down the cylinder. Will be a player that Tucker spots to the right. Now coming off the bench. Watch this. Tucker will look in. He occupies the defense. Right now in the cylinder, he'll wait. Just drop it inside, and Denikin takes the shot. First goal of the game. Philadelphia coming off strong, as they should here in their home field. And Buffalo, all year long, has been a slow starter. You see 1-0. But Buffalo, their worst quarter, John, is in this very first quarter. I keep calling you John, of course. Craig is what I should be saying.
Deflected wide by Dallas Elliott. Here come the Wings again. It took them only 24 seconds to get their first goal. Here's John Tucker to Mark Hahn. after playing with an injury, and take advantage of that.
Keep an eye on that. Yeah, they most definitely will. He's number two. He's the captain of the team, the leader. Watch him go for his ribs. He had cracked ribs in the game against New York.
Connolly goes for a deflected wide by Bill Gerrie. Fight behind the crease. Gerrie going at it with Marcon. A few more players get into it. Official blows. That will go to the Bandits.
Craig, again, team tendencies. Buffalo, slow starter. They can lose this first quarter because they lost almost every first quarter. The only quarter they won this year was against Philadelphia. They've lost almost every first quarter of this season. The second quarter is Buffalo's quarter. That's the one they own. They outscore the opponents usually 2-1. So they'll be okay if they can stay close in the first.
Elliott starts the fast break after the shot.
Now, if you're a Philadelphia fan, of course, you want to get that big lead in the first, and then you want to put the clamps on in the second.
Conley for the outside, you don't back of the net.
Well, this team has really missed John Conley from Towson State. He was a big offensive star last year, but he's had trouble getting to practices this year. Hasn't played that much, but look at that blazing shot from the outside. Third right-handed shot from John Conley. Way outside, and you can see how far out the great Gerrie is, which doesn't give Conley much to shoot at. He found the mark, though.
Both picked up the ball on their face-off, but then lost his stick. This is John Tavares. Hilch tries it. Turned over the bar by Elliott. Ball goes to midfield where Mahar is battling Rush for it. Rush trying to pick it up and try to get a break going. He redirects it back to midfield. Martin going after the ball. He'll take it back to Ricky Freed. 30-second clock will now begin.
I'm surprised that that shot from the outside beat Gerrie, because normally the way he comes so far out of the goal, he blocks any kind of great net to shoot at. Conley found it. I'm also surprised at the lack of team defense right now for Buffalo. Philadelphia really doing everything they have to do to get the good shot. They look excellent.
A whistle away from the ball is giving the ball to the Buffalo Bandits. Behind the back shot taken there by Keenan. Out the other side, this is foul. Foul tries to flip it to Keenan. He loses control of it. Elliott throws it in. Long ball. This is John Mastrand, who came over from the Baltimore Thunder at the beginning of the year. Gabrielson finds an opening. Save Gerrie! Does he have to go to his knees for that one?
Well, Gabrielson shot from the outside. Maybe not a great shot because they had Gerrie a little bit shaky. If they would have worked down for a high percentage shot, they had a chance to really shake his confidence for the whole first half. Gerrie comes up with that save. Now he feels a little bit better.
This is Bob Hamley, who had a great game against the Turbos last week. For Mike Moradian. Moradian from the outside. Six save Elliott. Right in front of the goal. Ball loose. Redirect attempted by Burnham. Whistle. And holding will be the ball.
Hold call. Denigan in there on the crease. They're really tying up the offense of the Buffalo Bandits. Philadelphia playing very, very physical. They've got a tremendously athletic roster.
Moradian at the wing. Position, that is. Goes in. Elliott with the deflection ball. Tucker. Brings it back to Elliott, but not before Bob Hamley gives a check to the six-year veteran. Billy Miller, number 99. After the line change, we'll run the show.
And Conley's on with this line along with Rush, but Conley is the guy who really put some offensive numbers last year, scored, of course, the last goal.
Miller against Burnham, behind the crease, looking for the centering pass. Burnham with an excellent marking opportunity there. Knocks the ball out of the way with a stick check. Miller dumps it into the corner, but that's a 30-second violation.
And you see that technique? Dave Evans wants them to do that. If they don't get the shot, don't take a sloppy shot where Buffalo can get the fast break the other way. Just push it into the corner. He simply rolled the ball in the corner and cut back on defense.
Gerrie Hilts with a low shot. Deflected wide by Elliott. Loose ball picked up by Darris Kilgour. Kilgour centers to Hilts. He couldn't find the handle on it. Mahar comes away with it. Kilgour tried a fancy pass. Deflected by Conley. Retaken by Kilgour. Inside shot taken by
Panetta, Flynn, Burt, and Matt Panetta out there for the Wings, dressed in their gray and black.
Matt Panetta, All-American from Johns Hopkins, playing with Chris Flynn. A little bit of fighting going on right now, but Panetta's one to watch. He didn't play the last 2 weeks because he was in England.
A little scuffle going on. We're going to take a break. Be back with more. The World Championship on Prime Network. Early moments, Dallas Elliott, brilliant in the net.
He has really been perfect back there. Watch the offensive push for Buffalo. Come right in, makes that sliding slap save. He's been tough high. He's also been tough very low. Again, a shot here on the high one, but he's been making those sweeping low saves as well. There he goes down low. Just impossible to beat. That's the kind of game he's going to have to play to keep Philly in.
The only time these teams have met, back on February 28th in Buffalo, 20-11 the final score, Buffalo winning that one.
And in the first quarter of that game, Philadelphia outshot Buffalo 22-14, yet they were behind 6-4 at the end of the first quarter.
Confusion on the restart. Referees want a new 30-second clock, and they'll get it as the Bandits dressed in their black, white, and orange. Usually fans here in the Spectrum root for those colors. Not in this particular occasion.
You know, Craig, there's a big Canadian-American thing going on here. We can talk about that a little bit. Tucker leading the American contingent of great players here, like Robbie Sheck, team All-American from Towson State, Panetta from Hopkins.
Alexander tried to put a nifty shot in there, but it went wide.
So the Canadians are bragging that, hey, they're the big scorers. They can play this game better than anybody. And the American guys are taking a little bit of offense to that kind of treatment. They want to prove it right here on this field.
All loose behind the crease. Gerrie back there to get it. It's back behind the crease. Tom Emmick back there to help him. Gerrie comes away with it. Fast break. Here comes Brian Hall. Hall tried to pass over. Keenan off the rebound. Elliott
will
pull it in rather calmly.
He didn't miss the net. He had an open shot at Elliott, and he took it high over the cage.
2-0, Wings leading, first quarter. Here's Billy Miller. Miller leaving. His shot hits the post.
What a great move by Miller. Hit the ball from Tucker and beats two players, and just misses that shot because of the 2-inch diameter of that pipe.
Fast break opportunity missed there by the Bandits as it was time for a scheduled line change. This is Bob Hamlin going against Rush. Receives the pick from Meridian. Pick and go. Elliott with a fantastic save again. Miller on the loose ball up to Hahn. He loses control of it. Burnham with a check.
Sensational defense, Craig, because these guys from Buffalo are tremendous finishers. And Elliott's been putting a big stop on those fast breaks and those pushes right into his face. They're shooting from right around the crease area. He's been sensational in the goal.
Day tries a shot from the outside. Elliott right there. Flynn back protecting the crease, helping out his goalie.
Philadelphia, 9 saves, ever won a big time save by Dallas Elliott.
Back to the back of the net. Flynn,
local hero, he's tremendous. He's an All-American player at 10. So the fans here in Philadelphia love him. This is a local favorite. Chris Flynn comes in, look at the little juke move, sets the defensive man so he can't move. Then he runs right around him for the right-handed shot and beats Gerrie, who has looked weak from the outside. Look at that shot right there. Flynn with his right knee bandage. He is a face-off specialist. There he is, facing off and winning.
Flynn will try to make it 2 in a row. Screen. Delayed penalty coming up. And the whistle blows. A penalty will be called. We'll throw you in when we return. Kilgour in the penalty box after a two-minute minor for cross-check.
Not bad habit of Darris Kilgour. He's a rough player, and he gets himself in the box a couple times. Now Dave Evans has to think about this. The last time these two teams met during the regular season, Buffalo scored five times when they were man down. Five times in this kind of situation when they had one man less in Philadelphia. So that's something they've worked very hard on. You'll see them hit the ball down low, try to work it from back around the frame of the goal.
Turner will run the show on the power play. This is Nostrand. In the corner to Tom Burke. Turner, no look pass. Stolen away by Brian Hall. This is John Tavares.
And Buffalo
for Alexander.
Craig Buffalo's pulled the goalie. They tried to get an even-up situation here. The goalie is out. Gerrie is not on the playing surface.
And a delayed penalty has been called. Take a look one more time at the work of Dallas Elliott.
He's been perfect in the goal so far. Right here, ball comes in loose. Tavares tried to slam dunk it. Not by Dallas Elliott, not in this game so far.
Well, after 30 seconds of a power play opportunity, the Wings find themselves now in a four-on-four situation as Tom Burton goes over to talk to the official. 6:10 to go, first quarter.
Scotty Boyle getting things squared away.
And Burt will go into the penalty box.
So this should make it 4-on-4. We've got one from each team in the penalty box. But we saw that power play, as we look at Darris Kilgour, power play by Philadelphia, the first one of the game, not successful. Now they're 4-on-4.
This is Keenan working it in. Takes the shot, Elliott falls, but still gets the save. Changes for both teams. Hahn has a breakaway.
Mark Hahn is maybe the oldest player in the league. One of the favorites here in Philadelphia, you don't have to tell you that. But his game is built on speed, even at 35. Boy, Tucker comes up, he looks to the bench, because they slid one guy in the bench on one side, Hahn comes out the other side, and that explosive speed, this is the way Buffalo does it as well, explosive speed beats the defense of Buffalo. Look at Hahn come down there, Hahn slam dunk, boom, gets up to the corner to freeze the goalie and just puts it behind Gerrie for goal number four. Beautifully done by Philadelphia, using the bench, getting Hahn in there, and his speed makes it goal number four.
The Bandits call timeout. We will return with more from the Spectrum. Welcome back to the Spectrum. Craig Johnson along with Leif Elsmo. 4-0 Wings, and I've got to sympathize with the fans watching back in Buffalo. They must feel a little weary right about now.
Tucker comes up, he looks to the bench. They slide one guy in the bench on the near side, then Hahn comes out the other side, and his speed just beats the defense, and he slam dunks that one for number four. Callie is now in the goal, number one, replacing Gerrie.
Ross Cowley in goal from Brock University. Six games this year, 170 saves. Brock University, the same school as the Turbos going to the Yankees.
I'd say that's a pretty early yank as far as I'm concerned, because Gerrie's been pretty good. This team hasn't won a first quarter except in the game they beat Philadelphia all year long, so it's not really do or die time yet. Now we've got Gerrie on the bench.
Tavares!
Can't say enough about him. He is a sensational player that can do it all. We talked about him in the pregame. He can score, he can feed. Tremendous ground ball staff. But watch him come in here. John Tavares gets this rebound right across in front of Elliott. Finds a spot and hits it. He would have made two more fakes had he needed that, but as soon as he saw a target, he took it. This ball comes off of Elliott. Elliott's not set yet. Now Elliott's going to go left to right, leave a little bit of room for Tavares. Tavares moving into the cylinder to get the full 4x4 to shoot out. 4x4.5.
Buffalo wins the faceoff. Bissell takes a shot, goes wide. Tavares on the loose ball, looking for the centering pass. Gets it out for Alexander. Alexander with a large shot. That's blocked out wide. Front by Flynn. Tavares takes the bouncer. It won't go either. Fight for the ball at midfield. Whistle blown against the Bandits.
Chip ball.
the next 30 seconds.
Line change, Tucker comes off, so does Flynn. Miller now controls, but this 4-on-4 really benefits, I think, Buffalo because the extra space makes it tough on the goalies with that great Canadian stick work.
10 seconds left on the 4-on-4 situation. Miller! But the officials wave it off! They say no goal!
Crease violation, step in the crease the last moment, a sensational move. Miller showing how deftly he can move between the defensive players. Miller comes in, watch him set the one defender, roll right inside him, pull the stick back, and he beats him, but he had stepped in the crease. One more look. Sets him up for a strong right-handed move, and now comes in one-on-one with Cowie.
Power play opportunity now for the next 20 seconds. The Hall of Famer, Alexander Kilgour. Elliott's mask right off, and Elliott may be hurt.
I have never seen this in the major indoor lacrosse league. Unbelievable. A shot that was probably over 100 miles an hour just ripped the face mask off Elliott, and he's down being looked at.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but didn't Dallas Elliott get knocked out the last game in a somewhat similar situation? I don't think it was a shot to the mask.
He was taken out, knocked unconscious for a few moments. Look at him. He's saying, man, that one was a bullet. He looked it right in the eyes, and now the trainer making sure he is okay. Metke's on the sideline, and Metke took him to two championships, so this is a good insurance policy for Evans.
Let's take a look at it and watch this one.
I can't imagine anybody who would want to play the goal in the major indoor lacrosse. Look at that shot by Kilgour. Just rips the face mask right off of Elliott. And that's the sensational style he's had this whole game of going up high, flailing the arm. Watch him stand up high, put his arm down, pull up the goal, and make the big save. And that shot just ripped it off his face. Tremendous save. He has been unbelievable. Now, he may have to come out of the game or else charge the timeout. I think the trainers are saying we want him off as a just to make sure that he's okay. Let's see. He's saying he's all right, but not that far from him. Craig, he's saying I'm okay to go.
And the Philadelphia Wings call a timeout to try to surmise the situation.
Well, if they don't call a timeout, they've got to change goalies. If they call a timeout, they can keep them in the game. I think that's why they're going to do it.
4:25 to go. First quarter, Wings 4, Bandits 1. As Dallas, I'm sure, has been asked all the regular questions like, where are you? And hopefully he said Philadelphia.
What is your name? All those tough ones.
Hopefully they didn't say, where are you? And he said, Dallas, what is your name, Philadelphia? That could be a little confusing.
Oh, it's going to be wild to see how that affects him. He's been unbelievable in this first quarter, but that's got to affect you. That thing just literally ripped his helmet off. And I can't imagine ignoring that when these shots come at you as the game progresses. This crowd, near sellout here in Philadelphia. They love the Philadelphia Wings and the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. Banner hanging high, 89 and 90 World Championship banner. Proudly lit, and they look up and see that thing and gives them an extra incentive to go for it. They've been there. They've done it.
A little repair work being done on Dallas Elliott.
4-1, the Wings, 4:25 to go, first quarter.
And I'm going to take a good hit. And I'm going to go ahead and try to do that one.
The Spectrum crowd on their feet for the return of Dallas Elliott to the net.
I tell you, what a folk hero he is. 5-1-4 now. He gets a chance to look at another hard shot. Power play Buffalo.
This is Keenan up top to Hamley. Hamley sends a high shot. It's caught in the back of the net. Alexander trying to stick in there to dislodge it.
What a little perfect save. He raises his arm. He comes up, fills up the goal, and raises his arms to cut off any corner shot. He's made probably half a dozen of those saves, and it's only the first quarter.
Both teams at full strength here. John Tucker will give it to Billy Miller. And with six on the shot clock, the Wings have to hurry. Miller will do just that. They'll dump it into the corner, and Buffalo will take it over. That's what you were talking about earlier.
Evans said that they don't want to give Buffalo the fast break. They don't want to take the sloppy shot, and then all of a sudden Buffalo is releasing and getting the easy fast break on the other end.
Darris Kilgour has the ball, has it dislodged for a moment, trying to power it in. Kilgour has to chase the loose ball once again.
John Conley, probably 50 pounds lighter, playing tremendous defense against Kilgour.
Tavares with a low shot as the 30-second clock almost ran down. Long pass, but a bad break for the Wings as it goes into the penalty box.
And you can tell the emotional level of the Wings is being a little bit turned down. They couldn't sustain that adrenaline rush they had in the first 10 minutes.
This is Mike Meridian. Centering pass, try to get it to O'Hanlon. Played off the board by McAvoy. John McAvoy. Went back for Chris Flynn. Ricky Free to run the show.
Ricky Free has become a real integral part of the offense. One of the new leaders going in for John Tucker as he gets ready to retire. But Free's got some great offensive numbers.
10 on the shot clock. Panetta working in against Hamlin. Spinning shot walk though. Holding the call. That'll be a new 30 for the Wings. And another opportunity.
Hamlin just wrapped him up down low. Hamlin, a big star in the offensive stats against the Detroit team. The big win that got him here.
Matt Panetta working against Day. This is Martin out front, centering top. Hurt with a quick shot, that will hit the post. Panetta tries to follow up, it won't go. Hurt off the rebound, Panetta going behind the crease. But Cowie brings it in. Meridian can't avoid everyone. Hamley with a check off the ball. Picked up by O'Hanlon, who sends it into the corner, and Elliott back there to get it for the win.
Very physical game. Philadelphia's really laying out more hits than they're taking right now. They've got some horsemen on the Philadelphia team, led by Tucker, who has never been shy about contact.
No scramble. He's got the score!
Well, Cowie didn't leave him much to shoot at. But don't forget, this is that left-hander we talked about. Nostrand has a little more to aim at because he's a lefty now. His stick is in the cylinder, so Cowie's got that margin covered, he thinks. But because Nostrand has a stick way out to the left, he finds the twine. Beautifully placed, about hip-high, favorite target spot for a lot of the team shooters. 5-1.
90 seconds to go in the quarter. Here's Hall, centering pass, Alex Hero, right in front, automatic to the back of the net. 4 Buffalo, 5-2, with 1:22 to go.
That's what's so frustrating about Buffalo. You can work your tail off to get the lead, but when they score, they make 3 or 4 passes, and it's easy. They don't burn up much energy.
Some of the Bandits fans enjoying that one.
1, 2, 3 passes, and Elliott, no chance. You're going to see a lot more of that as the game goes on. This is how they score. They feed better than anybody in the league. One pass, two pass, one-on-one with Elliott, finally beat them. Now don't forget, I've said it before, they don't win any first quarters. This is pretty much according to the way they played the season. Take nothing from Philadelphia.
All out front, looking for the shot, takes a high shot, that one hit. Elliott right in the face mask. Here's a last break opportunity, John Tucker. Ended up in a 1-on-4 situation as we go to the last minute of the period. Gabrielson will run the show, 15 on the 30-second clock.
Philadelphia has done everything perfectly in this first quarter. They are just where they want to be. Now the deadly second quarter coming up, and they've got to keep it going.
Dostrad with a shot. So many people thought that went into the goal, but it bounced off the board and came back. 30-second violation will give the ball to the Buffalo Bandits. Looking for a quick restart. Here's Darris Kilgour across the restraining line. Kilgour trying to fight his way in there. Hiltz tried to flip it to Tavares, who plays it off the board. Tavares around the pick. Tried to give and go. Tavares with a shot. Kilgour trying to redirect it. Ball loose in the corner. And with 10 seconds to go, the Wings may just hold on to it. And the Spectrum crowd on their feet after one.
seven goals, seven different scores, but one difference, Dallas Elliott.
He's been sensational. Evans is getting everything out of this Philadelphia club that he could possibly get. They've played a perfectly first quarter, and Elliott takes a blast here on a power play that knocks his helmet off. This is something that I've never seen in the indoor league, any league for that matter, really just whips it off. He stood that test to come back and have just a perfect first quarter for Dave Evans. Now, the test is the second quarter. And in my estimation, as we look at Gerrie back in the net for Buffalo, I think the team who wins this second quarter is going to win the championship.
Conley going in on Gerrie's stick save as he has the stick right down covering the old five ball.
Throughout the year, John, or Craig, this team Buffalo has really used the second quarter to propel their offense. They've outscored the other offenses 2-1 throughout the season here in the second quarter.
This is Tom Emmett over the Hall of Famer, Kevin Alexander, playing for the first time in the spectrum. Greeted by three Wings players.
Hey, Craig, you're letting them play a little bit. They're letting them go ahead and get physical on defense. You saw it.
Conley, centering pass, it's down. But Billy Miller's shot blocked by Gerrie.
So Les Bartley, the coach for, along with Buck McCready for Buffalo, made a big move there. Now Buck works for these goalies. He has enough confidence to take out Gerrie, let him settle down, and put him back in the game. Not typical substitution pattern.
Tavares looking for the centering pass. Dumps it in there. The hard try to redirect, but the Wings able to come away with it. Flynn against Bissell, picked up by Tavares. Panetta to Burke.
Panetta, a rookie from Hopkins, spent the last 2 weeks in England. He, along with Bob Schick, missed a couple games for this team.
Bird tries the shot. Martin gets the shot.
You can't do it any better than that. Martin, who is really known as a stingy defensive player, gets the rebound. Now, Gerrie doesn't have it. You make the save, you've got to collect that ball. Martin comes around. Nobody picks him up. Nobody makes the slide, and Martin, look at that, nice fit to keep the defense wide, and then untouched, comes in and makes a nice shot behind Gerrie. Boy, it's great when you can get goals from guys like Martin, who is a sensational player, but known for defense. When he starts supporting your offensive push, your team has a great feeling in the offensive flow.
6-2 with 13:06 to go in the first half. Martin from Burt, who's scoring on the last goal.
Philadelphia looks like their energy level is 90% of what it was at the beginning of the game. They are here to play.
Burnham checks Gabrielson into the board. Oscar jumps it to Elliott. Fast break opportunity. 3-on-3. This is Tucker with a shot.
Tucker saw something there. He saw a little scene. There were some players in front of the goalie. There's the shot clock winding down. He just wound up and flagged it.
Alexander to Veltman. Derek Keenan. The whistle blows. Veltman had lost his glove, and the officials blew the whistle because some of the Wings were pushing it away with their sticks.
Bob Hoynes trying to get it farther away from Veltman.
Keenan tried the shot. Elliott there again. Fast break opportunity. McAvoy is open.
Well, now it's Gerrie's turn down at the same end. They switch nets, you know, at the quarter. It's that crease area that has really been hot, blazing hot. Elliott in the first quarter, Gerrie making the sensational Hall of Fame type saves right here in quarter number two.
John Tavares working against Rush. Quick shot. Saved by Elliott.
He is so tough to beat today. And Tavares had it all his way. Made the big save, made the big fake rather, poked the defender. They cleared out for him. He came in for the shot. Elliott's just not going to let you get an easy goal.
John Conley Tavares off the rebound. Lead pass. There is Kilgour. Burt behind him looking for the stick check. Kilgour fires it in. Elliott with a stick save. Tavares goes flying in. His call for the loose ball push.
Tom Young sending it the other way. Refereeing here along with Scotty Boyles and who else down there?
I don't have my list handy.
Tamburino, Rich Tamburino is the third referee.
There's Chris Flynn. Flynn takes it out front, stick check away by Tavares. One-on-one situation. Tavares with a shot from the outside. Dallas Elliott, cool, calm, and collected in the net.
Well, that one, Tavares' greatest shot, right in the open red basket, just laid it right in his belly.
Panetta tried the centering pass to Burt.
But give credit to Philadelphia again because they dropped back, and I think that time it was Ricky Freed who played just good position defense, didn't give Tavares anything to shoot at.
We talked a lot about the play of Bob Hanley last week. Probably if you want to give him a runner-up for his like game MVP, he would have gotten it.
He really did have a great game. The game of the year. The game of the year in 92 for sure.
Mike Meridian tried that shot. Couldn't get it through. Here comes Martin. Has Dedekin in the middle if he wants him. Tucker has to jump up.
Tucker's the guy that Buffalo is really focusing on. You can see he doesn't have any goals yet. He's got a few assists, and that's all he wants. Tucker doesn't care who scores. And the defense for Buffalo is focusing on John Tucker.
Orange with a shot. That one wide. Three on the shot clock. And the 30-second clock has expired. Took the officials a few seconds to figure that out. There's Mike Moradia. The premier line, one of two for the Bandits out there. Hall tries the shot.
And that save, again, an unbelievable save by Elliott. He is on top of his game, making it impossible for the slick offense of Buffalo to beat him. But if you notice, that move, Craig, was a power move for Buffalo. When they're successful in making two, three, four passes, they've got to get back to their passing game.
We're going to take a break. Back with more on Pride Network.
Penalty right here. Tucker coming in, wrapping up and holding. Keep the ball back to Buffalo. It's going to be no time in the box, just possession call. 5-on-5. Penalty's not a factor, and of course that's what you expect in most championship games, Craig. They're letting the guys play, and really it has to be a flagrant foul to get time in the box.
Kevin Alexander on the restart against Freed. Alexander trying to get in, played out by Freed. Hall on the outside. Deflects it wide. New 30.
Heard much from Keenan, one of their offensive stars. He's got to light it up for them.
Emmett looked like he was going to go with a shot from the outside. Hall tries it, nailed from behind by Gabrielson. Now a fast break opportunity. Scott Gabrielson fires, but doesn't go anywhere.
Veltman and Keenan drop back and play beautiful position defense. Philly, though, really setting the tempo still. Been their game so far, obviously 6-2, but they are still pushing the tempo when they want and slowing things down when it suits their needs. Shots on goal, Buffalo leading, but Philadelphia is the one to count.
Phillips in front. Tavares with an opening chance call.
Well, he's not on the MIL All-Pro team. I don't know why voting is buying the teams in the league. What a move this was. You don't do it any better than this. Kilgour freezes the defense, sees Tavares, gets it to him. Now watch him right here lunge around the defender. One pick to get Elliott to his Elliott's left leaves the whole side open, and Tavares dives to the open net. Watch him freeze Elliott right there, and then dive to the open net, beats him at the hip. 6-3.
Good look at John Tavares.
And that's his second goal, Craig. So the leader in offense is doing his job. Two of the three goals by Tavares.
The Bandits with another opportunity. Tavares looking for a quick two. Finds Kilgour open. Kilgour puts it to the back of the net. It's 6-4, and the Bandits fans who made the trip to the Spectrum are enjoying that one.
Darris Kilgour, one of the leading scorers on this team. Watch how big a target he is in there. The hit by Conley just bounces off him, and once he gets Ellie up in the air, it's easy to beat him on the backside.
6-4, the Bandits with a comeback on Prime Network.
You think there's a little bit of a flak jacket underneath his uniform, and he's very, very tender from the game against New York.
Veltman off the faceoff, tried to flip it to Keenan, ball loose in front of the crease. Reeled in by Burt. Alexander on that last faceoff, winning the faceoff. He's had his problems in that area during the playoffs, winning only 12 while losing 23.
Kind of surprised the league with his control moves when he came in on this expansion team, Hall of Famer from Canada. But you're right, Greg, they've caught up to him here and are really beating him physically in the playoffs. He's not a big man, Kevin Alexander. About 160, 5'9", 5'9", area, 5'8".
A loose ball push gives the ball back to the Bandits with a new 30-second clock, 6:40 to go in the half. We'll take a look at the All-Pro teams coming up at halftime on the Coors Light Halftime Report. Here's Alexander against Matt Panetta. Out front for Tavares. 15 on the shot clock. Tavares kind of dumps it in the middle there.
Well, he made a great feed, really, to Kilgour. Kilgour was sitting there with his back to Tavares, asking for an over-the-shoulder feed.
Tavares with a shot as the 30-second clock just about to run out. Panetta comes away with the rebound, sends it to Tucker, who's wrapped up by Tavares.
Tavares playing both ends of the field, tough defense, great on ground balls. Tucker does the same. Two tremendous players in the major indoor lacrosse league, one against the other.
Hit away from the ball. No penalty called. Gabrielson with a shot deflected wide by Gerrie, and tempers are getting a little hot here at the Spectrum.
Now, Hill's got a little bit of an Oscar job. He's looking to get some retaliation, too. He was definitely nailed, but he stayed down there hoping to draw the flag. And we talked about it. These refs are letting them go.
You never want to see a championship game decided by one or two calls.
Nope, you want to keep him out of the penalty box, much like last week in Detroit. It was a little bit too many penalties in that game for championship caliber. Definitely decided in the penalty situations.
Pass bounces into the Buffalo bench. Turnover will give the ball to the Philadelphia Wings. And the line led by John Conley will run on this occasion. Shot from the outside by Conley, deflected by Gerrie. Bob Hamley will bring it down, looking for the long pass. Takes it just past midfield today. Here's Hamley. His shot goes low. Meridian off the rebound. The Wings lead it. Panetta with a shot. Gerrie down to his knees for the save.
Gerrie has looked strong and really showing that the confidence the team gave him by putting him back in the goal after that tricky first quarter. He's rewarding that confidence right now. Good move by the brain trust of Buffalo.
Veltman over to the far side for the Hall of Famer, Kevin Alexander.
Trey gets a little bit high and outside for Alexander. He's 35, and look at both knees are wrapped up. He needs to get the ball closer to the crease, make one or two moves and get the shot off. They've got to park him down low and try to get the ball to him. Buffalo is still not passing the ball with the two or three passes that make them efficient.
Delayed penalty coming up. The goaltender is pulled. It's a sixth attacker situation now for the Philadelphia Wings. And they don't realize that it's a sixth attacker situation. Doesn't matter. They get a goal anyway. Paul Dedekin. And that one will start a little scuffle. But the fans here
two for him. Watch him get the ball behind. He'll come around for a little slam dunk move way at the crease behind the back. A little like a backhanded shot showing tremendous athleticism. Now Gerrie will come to him, but he just reaches right around Gerrie and finds the open net. Tremendous play. No slide of the defense, but...
Welcome back to the Spectrum in Philadelphia. Craig Johnson, Leif Elsmo, and a few thousand people in the stands. One more look at this pretty goalie.
Well, great reach here and threw a backhanded shot. He didn't bother turning around, didn't have time to. Hall slides in a little bit late and then gives him a shot to the face. Buffalo's not used to being behind. They lost those first three games in the season, as did Philadelphia. There's Mike Page, who runs the offense for Dave Evans' club there, the Philadelphia Wings. Tucker getting in line. They like to run one or two lengths of the field and then change the line. They run three, four lines.
Buffalo's used to playing in front of big crowds at home at the odd, but this is the largest crowd they've played against.
Largest enemy crowd, right. This is a crowd that is not behind them. And I think worse than that, Craig, is how far can they go being behind without affecting them mentally? They've had a lot of confidence, but Philadelphia has controlled this game.
Panetta trying to add one more to the Wings tally. Darris Kilgour. Tavares.
Beautifully read by Elliott. Tavares had it screened totally, but Elliott went to the far pipe blindly and cut that shot down.
And it's getting a little rough as Matt Panetta gingerly goes off the field. In front, Tavares with a shot. He thought he had caught the corner. Darris Kilgour off the rebound. Tavares will try it again. But the stick check by Ricky Freed.
Hold call. We'll give it back to Buffalo and reset the shot clock. But Philadelphia is dishing out the hits. This team is not going to let this opportunity go away. They snuck into the playoff picture. Big wins against Baltimore, then New York, now the championship game.
Meridian out front. Pass reeled in by Jim Bissell. Mike Meridian, spin, looking for the shot. Played out of the crease. Two on the shot clock as it will run out on the Bandits. Good defensive rally there by the Wings. Tucker moving in. Looking for the goal. Takes the shot low.
Tries to go to the five hole right between the legs of Gerrie, but he was there with that big goalie net, that big goalie stick, to turn that one away.
Things have quieted down quite a bit here at the Spectrum.
2-2 in this quarter, Craig. My prediction will be kind of foggy if it ends up 2-2.
Keenan trying to power it in. Out shot deflected by Elliott. Emmett comes away with it. And an interception. And look at the speed of John Nostrand.
Keenan matched him stride for stride when he's once he split that seam. Dave Evans now, his team with 16 on the shot clock, 46 in the quarter.
And the Wings would love to have one more on the board.
Alexander gets that ball. You can see the 35-year-old Lake just didn't want to take off. He's a younger man. He's up the field and sprinting toward the goal.
25 on the scoreboard clock. Alexander against Billy Miller. Alexander behind the net. It won't go. Bissell going after the loose ball. 13 on the scoreboard clock. Hits. Low shot. Deflected wide by Elliott.
Glove save by Elliott. Tremendous save. And the ball goes back to his teammates in Philadelphia. He has been the story of the first half. He has really taken Dave Evans' game plan, working to perfection with big saves and the goal.
And a penalty will be called on a hit away from the ball. McAvoy went after Jerry Hill. And Dave Evans, very annoyed at that particular call.
It'll be tough to get a shot here at the end of this half. He's got
got 4 seconds to do it. But the killer here is that with control of the game, Evans knows that he's going to start the second half a man down. Timeout now called by Buffalo. They want to try to get that shot off, Craig. They've got 4 seconds, not much time to get that shot, but boy, they'd love to get the goal.
And I'm sure that Buck McCready and the entire coaching staff would like to get Bill Gerrie out, bring in a sixth attacker.
Good call, because that's exactly what they're doing. They called the timeout. They pulled Gerrie. They're going to put six guys on the offensive end of the field against four and the goalie for Philadelphia. So a two-player advantage. They only have time for the one shot, so it'll be very, very quick. They've got one pass to make before they shoot.
Dave Evans talking to his team.
Now they've got a tough job, the defenders. It's going to be a one shot, obviously. He's got 4 seconds, so maybe one quick cut, but more likely one guy, somebody pushed to the center to create a cavity or some space. They might make one pass and they'll take the shot.
Gerrie will stay on the field, so it will not be a sixth attacker situation. Keenan will have the ball at midfield.
Right, midfield's a little far away, so it's going to be very, very quick. I don't know if they'll get a chance.
Keenan lines up, fires to the back of the net as the buzzer sounds.
He did it. The unthinkable. Starting at midfield, Keenan comes down. Everybody else just stood their ground, and he beats Darris Kilgour. As we look at Elliott, who has been unbeatable the whole first half. That one does not feel good when you go to the half into the locker room, knowing you've controlled the whole first half except for the last 4 seconds. 3-2-1, goal number 5.
7-5 at halftime, the Wings with the lead. The Coors Light Halftime Report coming up when we return the World Championship on 5 Network. Halftime Report brought to you by Coors Light. It's the right beer now, and this was the right shot now to end the half for the Buffalo Bandits. Derek Keenan at the buzzer. 7-5 the score at halftime. We talked a little bit about the leaders last week. Let's take a look at the MILL All-Pro teams for the year 1992 on our Coors Light Halftime Report. Stars for five different teams are featured on the 1992 First Team MILL All-Pro team. Leading off the 92 First Team, the league's leading scorer, Detroit's Paul Gate.
It only took Paul Gate 2 years to become the league's all-time leader with 88 goals. This season, 33 goals, 20 assists. Look at that rocket shot from the outside. He is a tremendous offensive force. Paul, along with his brother Gerrie, have led the Turbos in offensive categories for the last 2 years. Outside shooter, yes, but watch how he takes it inside. The deft moves have made him the most potent scorer in the league.
The twin Turbos always seem to travel together, even in all-pro terms. Gerrie Gate, also a first-teamer.
27 goals, 22 assists, and Gerrie is currently the number 5 all-time leader in assists in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. 61 for his career, and this combination has really scared the other teams in the league.
In his sixth and final year with the Wings, the Philadelphia legend John Tucker goes out in style.
Well, quite simply, one of the best players to ever play the game. 16 goals, 21 assists this year. He'll go out and retire this year as the all-time leader for the Wings in goals, assists, and total points.
Another player who played his last season from the Baltimore Thunder, Rick Soule.
Rick Soule brought the Baltimore Thunder into the playoffs the last 2 years. A tremendous force on both ends of the field, offensively and defensively. His offensive numbers, very, very credible. Goals scored 62, assists 81, total point 143 for Ricky Soule.
From Pittsburgh, the biggest bull of them all, Dave Petromala, receives first-team honors.
A man like Dave Petromala, voted the best defensively in field lacrosse, has come forward to play the offensive game with Major Indoor Lacrosse. 10 goals, 12 assists. He has made a force for himself in the offensive stats for the Major Indoor Lacrosse League.
And in goal on the first team All-Pro for 1992 from the New York Saints, Sal Lacasio.
And Sal's had his best season yet. Tremendous year. Had the best game of the season against Buffalo, January 4th, 48 saves. Lacasio kept the Saints in the divisional hunt, actually winning the division for the American division, losing in the playoffs, not making it to the championship game. The success of New York was predicated on the success of big Sal Lacasio in the goal.
Another look at the first team All-Pros for 1992. And both teams in the championship final are well represented in the second team.
Three Buffalo Bandits. Let's go through the whole roster. Jeff Jackson from Baltimore, Derek Keenan from Buffalo, Darris Kilgour from Buffalo, and Jim Veltman from Buffalo. John Nostrand from Philadelphia and Dallas Elliott from the Wings round out the second team All-Pros.
That's the All-Pros for 1992. And we'll be back with more of the Coors Light Halftime Report from the Spectrum in Philadelphia. The Wings with a two-goal lead at halftime. Halftime Report. And standing by with Leif Elsmo, the man who in the first half had his bell rung a little bit. Leif standing by with Dallas Elliott. Leif?
Well, Craig, that is exactly right. The story of the first half, Dallas Elliott. A lot of pressure on you, Dallas. You knew that you're going to get a lot of offense in your face, and that's literally what happened when Darris Kilgour took your face mask off. But you have had a sensational first half. You must feel like you're on top of your game.
Well, I tell you what, Leif, the guys, our defense, were clearing the guys out in front of me, and I'm getting to see the ball better than I have the last few games. Buffalo, their lineup, they're full with the hot shooters, and they can stick the ball when they want to. If we can keep them out of that five-foot perimeter around the goal, I think we'll be okay.
I think you frustrated them. They've changed their shooting style. They're not passing as much. I think your play has contributed to that. Tell me about that last goal in the first half, though. You made a lot of highlight reel kind of saves, but that last one seemed to be one that you would have saved 9 out of 10 times.
Yeah, well, that was the one time it got by me. It looked to me as though Ricky Freed tipped the stick when he swung at it, and you don't let a guy like Derek Keenan run down the middle like that and take a wide-open shot. It was a bad goal, granted.
Dallas, last thing, where our fans at home are watching you, your style is dramatic. You come up on the shot, you read it high, and you fill the top of the goal. Is that by plan? You're trying to cut those corners off with your arm?
I try to. I have done that all my life, reacted that way, where some goalies stand there and let the ball hit them. I don't know if you could say give and take, maybe.
All right, well, our congratulations for a sensational first half. The only bad part about that is you got one more half to go.
Yeah, thank you, Leif.
All right, good luck to it. Go back to the locker room. And now we've got Johnny Tavares. We're going to bring him in for a moment at our Coors Light halftime. Right here, John, come over here. Just come in and turn around. Fans back home can see it. It's been a tough first half. This team came to play from Philadelphia.
They did. We knew it wasn't going to be a cakewalk. They're playing hard defense, getting good goaltending. It's a good game so far.
Now, it seems like because of the great goaltending by Dallas Elliott, it's almost taking your offense out of its sink. You're not making as many passes as I normally see you make.
You're right. We're starting to rush the ball one-on-one. We got to calm the pace down, use the 30-second clock, and use all our players on offense.
I just talked to Dallas Elliott, and you know he's had a sensational first half. What does that do to an offensive shooter mentally?
It gets you guessing. When you start guessing your first shot, you start going to your backup shots. So you don't know where you're going to go with the ball, so you hesitate. You don't shoot the ball as hard.
One of the greatest goals I've seen this year was the one where you came down. You had a couple great ones in this first half, but the one where you came down and made the big move, lunged across the cylinder to make the big shot. You know you had to go the extra mile against Dallas.
Yeah, I committed my full body. I figured to go with everything. I just came around with my stick.
So this has been a great first half. If the game's close enough, I think it's anybody's to take.
You're right. Right now, it's a goaltender's game. I think whoever plays best goalie right now is going to win the game.
All right, Johnny Tavares, the offensive leader for the Bandits against the great defense of Dallas Elliott. We'll be back in just a moment. Craig, take it from here.
Hi, everybody. This is Bizarre Jerry Yeager, our host of Fan Forums here on Monday night on the Empire Sports Network. You know, we love your calls that we get here, and the calls are great, but we'd also like you to come down and be part of our studio audience live. It's one of the few programs that give you a chance to come in here live, discuss your opinions not only here with me, but with our callers who call in here. So if you want to come down and be part of the show, here's what you do. Give us a call here at the Empire Sports Network. The number is 827-4289. Be a hometown hero here on Fan Forum.
Back at the Coors Light halftime report, 7-5, the Wings with the lead. Let's take a look at some of the halftime numbers.
Well, we came in knowing that one team was big on offense, that's Buffalo, and one team was big on defense, that's Philadelphia. Shots on goal, Buffalo outnumbering by 10, Philadelphia's shots on goal, but the ones that counted give the lead to Philadelphia by 2. Total shots, Buffalo way up again, face-offs, Philadelphia leading and controlling there, and ground balls to Buffalo. Tavares leading in the scoring area. We predicted that because this guy is one of the best in the league. 2-1. Kilgour, 1-1. Helps with 2 assists. For Philly, Tucker leading the way. The 3 assists really setting the table for the offense. Denikin with 2 dramatic goals. And Elliott not only making the big saves, but dishing it out on the outlet.
Back with the second half. Face-off. Big welcome to you folks watching on the Empire Sports Network back in Buffalo. Here's some of the people who made the trip. You're going to need to cheer your... Five, the Wings with the lead. Let's take a look at some of the halftime numbers.
Well, we came in knowing that one team was big on offense, that's Buffalo, and one team was big on defense, that's Philadelphia. Shots on goal, Buffalo outnumbering by 10, Philadelphia's shots on goal, but the ones that counted give the lead to Philadelphia by 2. Total shots, Buffalo way up again, face-offs, Philadelphia leading and controlling there, and ground balls to Buffalo. Tavares leading in the scoring area. We predicted that because this guy is one of the best in the league. 2-1. Kilgour, 1-1. Helps with 2 assists. For Philly, Tucker leading the way. The 3 assists really setting the table for the offense. Denikin with 2 dramatic goals. And Elliott not only making the big saves, but dishing it out on the outlet.
Back with the second half. Face off. Big welcome to you folks watching on the Empire Sports Network back in Buffalo. Here's some of the people who made the trip. You're going to need to cheer your Bandits on in half number 2. In the Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, 7-5. The Philadelphia Wings with a 2-goal lead at halftime. For those of you who might want to get into the statistics of things a little more.
Here we are again for the statistics. You can see the offensive categories, the shots on goal, SOG, the total shots, all in favor of Buffalo. Ground balls, they control more of those. Face-offs a little bit in favor of Philadelphia, but the big goals counted. Philadelphia taking better aim, and the big saves by Elliott, Tavares, Kilgour, Hiltz leading the offense for the Bandits. And, of course, Tucker with the 3 assists setting at the table for the scorers. Denikin, most prominent, making 2 dramatic goals. And Elliott not only making the big saves, but he also had 2 assists. Elliott takes a rest. Now in the goal, Dwight Metke. Metke, goalie for the 2 world championships that Philadelphia experienced. Evans was here as the coach. Evans has confidence in Metke, and he's putting him in there to make the difference now.
And Flynn takes the opening face-off right to Bill Gerrie.
Was put a specialist at the University of Pennsylvania, and he did that many times in the field game, going right down the field and taking the shot.
Bandits looking to get the first score of the second half after getting the last of the first. Alexander, nifty stick work, gets the shot off.
Played by Tucker. Those two have gone head-to-head in world competition. The last time, 2 years ago, in Australia. Canada against the U.S.
John Nostrand with a shot. Hits Gabrielson in the back. He tries to get the loose ball. Gerrie out of the crease. Gabrielson going at it along with Hall for Buffalo.
A lot of time with the shot clock.
John Tucker fires. Goes too far. Gets the rebound after a wacky bounce.
This is a nice offensive set for Dave Evans' team. Tucker with the right hand. He got Noster on the left.
Tucker shot.
Just picked out of the air by Alexander.
And now Alexander, 1-on-2.
He's such a magician, that stick. Now he's tired. He's coming off. That was a long sprint. On those weak knees. Got some damaged knees from a lot of great playing from Canada.
This is Tavares against Denikin. Around the pick by Hiltz. Darris Kilgour in traffic. Martin picks it off. Martin on the fast break against Hiltz. Has a trailer in Hoynes or Denikin. Goes to Hoynes, but the pass is too high.
Another fast break now. You're going to have the entire defense. Tucker's waiting for the D.
Here is Hiltz all the way. But he can't get the shot off. Nice stick check by Tucker.
Swatted it down, Craig. He just waited for the last moment. Just took the big windshield wiper swipe and knocked it out of the stick.
We played a little more than 2 minutes in the third quarter. 7-5 the score. Here's Billy Miller. Out front for McAvoy. shot clock. Miller. And once again, an offensive possession by the Wings without a goal.
Well, both teams have had a chance to get that big first goal of the third quarter. That really sets the tone for the second half. But the goalies have come up big, and they have the whole first half.
Mike Meradian fires from the outside. Netke with a stick save.
Remember, Netke some favors there, Craig, by taking those shots from outside. Netke, don't forget, didn't play at all in the first half. They're giving him those shots that he can easily read and get comfortable by making the saves.
Reed will be joined by Rob Scheck and Chris Flynn.
Nobody in that field has a bigger heart than Chris Flynn, number nine. And that'll be a penalty. Delayed call. It'll be 2 minutes in the box, but they'll have a chance to shoot first.
Well, the 30-second clock runs out. So that will mean a penalty will be called right here against the Buffalo Bandits.
Tough time for it. Mark Burnham from Syracuse goes in the box and gives Philadelphia a one-man advantage.
Present your Buffalo Bandits. Call now to reserve your ticket to all the excitement and all the action. Call 716-856-7300 or 1-800-333-PUCK. Your 1993 Buffalo Bandits season tickets. The hottest ticket in town. CY Bandits Lacrosse is the best four quarters of excitement for your dollar. Get your 1993 season tickets now. We'll sell you the whole seat, but you'll only need the end.
Box after a slashing call.
We haven't had too many penalties. Don't forget, five goals scored on man down from Buffalo in the last game. This is a different game. Philadelphia is in control. Two-goal lead.
John Tucker out front.
What Evans wants to do, Craig, is work the ball lower. It's up high right now, but he wants to work it lower, not to give him the fast break.
Nostrand with a shot. Gerrie with a save. New 30-second clock. And the push will give the ball back to the Wings.
We got Tavares and Kilgour on top of that man down. Two good shooters.
Colin Veltman, the low man. Nostrand couldn't get the shot off. Battle for the ball along the boards. Redirected to midfield. Actually back way into the defensive zone, and that's a backcourt violation.
Gives control to Veltman and the Buffalo Bandits.
1-12 in the penalty to Mark Burnham.
Now this is tough. You've got a man advantage, so normally you would double-team the ball, but it's dangerous against a team that has the excellent stick skills of the Bandits. Alexander, the crafty veteran, watch it. They'll try to press him for the ball. He gets rid of it right away. Tough position for Philadelphia. Man advantage, and they can't take advantage of it.
9 on the 30. The shot taken by Veltman on the outside. Metke reels it in.
Resch is absolutely tackling Tavares.
And a backcourt violation called once again against the Wings. If you're in a man-up situation, you can't take the ball back into the defensive end of the field once you stepped onto the offensive end, similar to the basketball rule there.
Everything's built for speed in the major indoor lacrosse league. No holding the ball, no delays, no four-quarter offense.
Kilgour in front, deflected wide by Netke. New 30-second clock. 15 on the power play is Billy Miller.
Well, I'll tell you what, win or lose, Philadelphia is going to, it looks like, keep Buffalo to the lowest scoring output of the season. Right now that's at 16 goals, and they're not going to even make that today.
Here's Nostrand, or Nostrand as some people call him. Tucker with a shot, brought in by Gerrie.
So right now the power play, no factor.
O'Hanlon, Tavares fighting with Tucker.
And Tavares had the chance for a one-on-one shot. He took his eye off and he was looking to set up the shot against Metke. Good ball movement. That was more typical of the Buffalo offense. And Tavares looked off the ball and missed the feed.
I'll make a change.
The Spectrum in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, 7-5. The Wings.
Third quarter
with
action.
With a lead.
Following up this third quarter of action. Following up on the second quarter that was really brilliantly played. 5 goals scored, 3 for Buffalo, 2 for Philadelphia.
And we played 5 minutes and 40 seconds, an eternity in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League without a goal.
So Philadelphia had an extra man. They didn't get a goal on it. Now Buffalo's turn to take a shot.
Keenan tries the first.
A different goalie than the first half. Metke's in there now taking the offense of Buffalo.
Alexander flips it in the corner for Tavares, going against Resch. Resch plays Tavares off the ball with the body. Billy Miller slips but maintains possession of the ball. He's got a lot of shooting strings.
Look at the moves of Miller.
Tried to get the pass, but it wasn't directed well.
But great defense, you can notice, on Tavares. They're really focusing on Tavares, number 11.
Tavares taken down on the clothesline.
Ricky Freed. Freed just bulldogged him, took him down by the head. Scott Boyle was right there to make the call. Watch this. Freed goes up high and just yanks him down. He gets inside him, and Freed says, nope, nope, nope. You can score on the extra man, maybe, but you're not going to get this one.
Well, two men now in the penalty box, and that will bring up a super power play for the Buffalo Bandits. An excellent opportunity. They had a couple of these last week against the against the Turbos. Didn't take them long there. Alexander with a goal.
Well, they needed that one big time. If you're a Buffalo fan, you've got to take advantage of it. Philadelphia gave you the chance to score, but their defense has been sensational. They needed that goal. Look at no emotion there. Buffalo's got a long way to go. They give it to him. It's on the board. Watch. Comes in. Big save by Metke, but then Alexander picks it up and just dumps it behind his back. Here, one more time. It's in. Alexander picks it up. Look at right away. Redirects it over the back. Gets hit from behind. Too late.
The fans watching back in Buffalo may have thought that I wasn't too enthusiastic in the goal call there, but Alexander, very businesslike, putting it there, and all of a sudden there's a kind of hush all over the spectrum.
Well, he's seen big goals. He's scored big goals. He's not overcome by the huge crowd or the importance of that one. That's just another one in the notch of a Hall of Fame player. He's already in the Hall of Fame. He was retired for 5 years to make him eligible for the Hall of Fame. He was elected this year, and the same year he comes out of retirement to play in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League.
Power play still, this time a one-man advantage for the next 1 minute and 40 seconds.
On the power play,
Hamley ties it up.
Hamley was the big offensive star in Detroit, and now he comes in. Boy, it looked like there was nothing to that shot. I'm sure Metke thought, as we look at Metke a little bit dazed, Metke thought he was going to feed. Watch how he looked to the left, looked to the right. There's a little bit of look to the left. Freezes the goalie for a second and sees a little bit of a corner to shoot at. What a marksman Hamley is from up top. From Metke's perspective, Hamley looks over to the left. Now this ball isn't to Hamley yet. Now he's got it. Metke positioned way high, but he left a little bit of a target. Marksman Hamley from the top.
One more time. As Bob Hamley has tied the world championship game up, 7 goals apiece with 8 minutes to go. Freed intercepts the ball off the faceoff.
Greg Evans didn't want to get into a power play situation with his team because they scored 8 out of 10 chances at Detroit. He wanted to stay out of the penalty box. In the second half, that philosophy has evaded his players here, and they got themselves into a jam. 2 power play goals.
Tom Burt in the corner sends it out for Chris Flynn. Flynn in traffic, goes through traffic, gets it over to Burt. His shot deflected before it even got to Gerrie. Tries it again. That one hit the post. Alexander very cautious as he takes it back to Bill Gerrie.
Rocket shot off the pipe. Buffalo now can control it. Boy, they don't look like they're at least been emotionally involved in this game. Very calm, Buffalo.
Diving shot taken by Darris Kilgour.
And Greg, another clear out. They ran one for Tavares in the first half. That time they ran a clear out for Kilgour. Big and strong. He got the shot.
Tucker gets around Tavares. Tucker puts it into fourth gear. And puts it to the back of the net.
Talk about the man. This is the man. Tucker saw a seam. He accelerates, comes right down to a one-on-one,
just a little nifty move there. Freezes Gerrie and just hits the spot. Tucker does not look dramatic when he shoots, but he is so effective. Acceleration. Comes in right in the crease, watches foot on the crease. Ooh, just knew exactly where to step, hit the spot. Nobody can pull this team up from the floor like John Tucker.
To paraphrase Alfred E. Newman, what, knee injured? Ostrand breaking away.
Well, we've seen Tucker in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League play through a lot of bad injuries. Separated shoulder last year, and he was here playing to try to keep that team in the playoffs. He wants the ball.
Tucker in against Hamlin. Out to Nostrand. This shot deflected wide. Day redirecting the ball to Hamlin. Gabrielson with a big hit. Wings with a one-goal lead. 8-7. 6:17 to go. Third quarter.
That's what leadership's all about.
Moradian. Point-blank shot taken by Hamlin. Couldn't get it through. Moradian. Moving this third line.
8 seconds left on the shot clock. Six now.
This is Day. He doesn't see the shot clock there. Well, maybe he did as he dumps it right towards the goal. And that starts a fast break.
That was pretty stupid. He hit it right into the goalie's glove, and then he go ahead and throws the outlet pass to start the fast break.
Gerrie out of the crease. Spectrum.
Big time goal for Philadelphia. That mistake started on the defensive end, and they just threw it right in the stick of Mecki. Comes back up, they dish it out in front. I couldn't even tell. Was it Denikin, number three?
Well, let's see. McAvoy.
McAvoy puts that one in. Great ball movement for Philadelphia. This team is going to be very difficult to beat. They know how to win. They've put on a big rush here late in the season. Chance to win it all. McAvoy comes in. Goal number nine.
And Bill Gerrie walking back to his net. Buffalo had tied the game, but Philadelphia now with a lead.
It wasn't Gerrie's fault. They've been getting shots right in the space. Look at the speed all the way across. Where's the defense? Not there. Hamlin let McAvoy go right behind him and pick up that feed. Tremendous cut by McAvoy. Game was tied at seven, and that's when Tucker stepped up and said, not tonight, guys. And he gives his team an 8-7 lead. Then McAvoy makes it 9-7. Each team has scored twice in this third quarter, but both of the Bandits' goals have been on a power play. No even set goals.
Ball is open in front, but Emmett could not get the ball to him. That's a loose ball push. On the whistle, the possession will go back to the Bandits. Matter of fact, one of those goals, a super power play.
There you go, right over the top. Looks like Bigfoot the Tracker coming over top there. Paul gets the call. Bandits get the ball. They haven't seen Metke this year. Good call by Evans, putting Metke in the goal in the second half. He has been absolutely sensational.
Alexander tripped out front, still got the shot away. And a fast break opportunity. Emmett going a little high on the hit, but no call.
Alexander gave it his all, came there with the two fakes, went behind it, just missed that slam dunk we call right behind the goalie.
Chris Flynn. Out to the point for Freed. Save Gerrie.
Buffalo definitely out of their shooting style. Philadelphia has taken them out of their normal offensive rotation where they're getting a lot of passes and making the goalie move.
Darris Kilgour powering it in.
That's a lot of what we're seeing, Greg. We're seeing a one-on-one, which is not Buffalo's success. Their success is moving the ball. Three passes. Goalie slides right to left. He can't make a save.
Off the restart, Mahar tried to redirect the pass by Hills. Tavares and Bissell fighting for the ball for the Bandits. Tavares comes away with it. The trailer is Hiltz. He can't get it by Mecki. Redirect. But there is no redirect. Sheck took it right out of midair. Takes it up to Flynn. Flynn nailed from behind the
but not before he gets it away to Rob Owens.
That's nothing to Chris Gwynn. He played on the football team at Penn, too. Tough, tough kid. He'll take those hits all day long.
Here's John Nostrand. Back to Flint. Five on the shot clock. His shot goes wide. Nostrand off the rebound, but that'll be a 30-second violation.
30-second violation.
Kilgour with a long pass. Gets it up to Tavares. Nice defense from behind there. Courtesy of Shaq.
Now they're letting him play. Tavares got nailed from behind, but no call by the referee. Who's right there. They're letting him go.
Tucker takes the shot.
Outlet all the way down again to Tavares.
Tavares looking for some help. He has to go against Tucker and Denikin, and Tucker takes it over. Counterattack as we go back and forth and back and forth. 3 minutes to go in quarter number three.
Philadelphia is reacting well to what the referees are allowing to happen. Buffalo is not reacting well. They are not stepping up the physical contact. Saves right there. 34-20. Buffalo, if they want to get this game, are going to have to start playing tough and physical like the referees are allowing. They've got to start nailing Philadelphia.
Mark Burnham. An eye behind them just in case. Here's Kevin Alexander.
What's happening, Greg, is on the offense, they're waiting for the call, get wrapped up and tackled. They think they're going to get the call, and they don't.
Oh, shot deflected wide. 2:30 on the shot clock. All stick checked away. Possible break. Conley against Keenan. Conley has two trailers. Conley will try to take it all the way in. Plays it out to Gabe Wilson, his shot wide. And now a one-on-one opportunity. Hamlin, but Tucker had stayed back. The bounce pass to Hall, who has trouble controlling. Here's Keenan. Keenan takes the shot from the outside. Rush took it back to Mickey, and I think Mickey may have said, hold on a second, not so tough.
I tell you, the referees are going maybe a little too far as I'm concerned. They're letting a lot of these plays. Offensive players getting shoved from behind as they're shooting. They're just letting go about as far as you can in the envelope of safety. Philadelphia controlling the ball from the first faceoff.
As the 30-second clock wound down, the dump into the corner. 1:15 to go in the third quarter. Two goals for each team. This will try to get it in front for Kilgour. Hiltz pulls it out the other side. 10 on the 30. Hiltz around the pitch, takes the shot. Kicks Dave Alexander with a follow-up. And the score.
Alexander can get that garbage shot better than anybody in the league. His stick is so accurate. He parks himself down for the right-handed shot. You've seen him do it today already. And this is where he's made a living in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League offensively. Watch the offense come in. The good save as it bounces out. But then Alexander right there for the follow-up. And Metke is out of position. That was a major, huge goal for a Buffalo team.
Buffalo goal, second this evening.
Philadelphia worked very hard. Third goal of the quarter. As the Buffalo fans have something to rejoice about. Third goal of the quarter for Buffalo.
5:14:02.
They're closing that gap. Interesting fact, Craig. During the season for both of these teams, any game they were in, whoever led at the end of the third quarter won the game. Whoever was leading at the end of the third quarter in every game for both these teams won the game.
And there are slightly under 45 seconds left in this quarter. And Tucker going to slow it down. Whistle blows, and I thought for sure we were going to see a penalty call. One of the officials was flailing his arms. Thought he was going to stop the clock. 22.
Blown the shot clock. Shot clock expired. Those shots went in there. They actually missed the 4x4.5-foot goal. Now 18 seconds. Buffalo may get a chance to shoot.
Terry Hills picked up the ball at midfield as the official had placed the ball down for a restart, trying to throw it back, and Hilt stole the ball, went the other way, and almost had a fast break.
Well, now we've got to pay attention to see the shot clock winding down. They put one in there with 1 second to go in the second quarter. Can they do it in the third?
There's Derek Keenan, shoving and driving. illegal hits. Kilgour remains.
Kilgour's a tough player. I tell you, if anybody can answer the call, Philadelphia's been dishing out the physical contact.
Ball loose in front of the crease as the horn blows, ending the third quarter. The Major Indoor Lacrosse League World Championship game has 15 minutes to go. 9-8, the Philadelphia Wings with a one-goal lead.
Take a look at the score by quarter.
And if your numbers buff again, whoever's been leading at the end of the third quarter has won each game involving these two teams. Here's another number. Philadelphia, all their wins, they've won the second and third quarter combined. In this game, they didn't win the second and third quarter combined. Does that matter? Probably not. They're in the spectrum. They're playing great, and it's anybody's game, 9-8.
Kevin Alexander on the faceoff with Chris Flynn, and it flies into the stands. The possession, however, will go to the Wings. Some of the fans here at the Wings. And at the Spectrum,
they love it.
Getting dressed up.
Boy, they love it here. They love those two championship seasons, and they want to see another one here tonight.
Here's Miller behind the crease. Alexander talking Gerrie through it. 9 on the shot clock. Conley with 1 on the shot clock. And the 30-second violation is no Bandit player had gained possession of the ball.
Well, you couldn't ask for a better game. Defense dominates in every championship of most every sport, and no difference here in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. Now it's up for grabs. One goal separates these two great teams.
Keenan mishandles the ball. Pulled in by Veltman on the loose ball. Veltman moving in, trying to get the shot. Laid physically up by Conley. Veltman tried to juke, lost the ball, 5 on the shot clock. Veltman is in front, but can't get the ball.
They'll lose it.
Wings take the ball.
Here's McAvoy. Over to Mark Hahn, to Burke, the trailer. Shot goes wide. Gerrie Martin on the loose ball, moving in towards the goal. Ricky Freed. Matt Panetta. Panetta with a juke move. 2 on the shot clock. Takes the shot.
Another chance for offense there. Really not a great shot taking. Panetta, a sensational player from Hopkins, but they need that experience. Ricky Freed had the ball up front. He's been in the league a few years. He knows those box shooting techniques a little better than Panetta.
Tavares tried to loop it for Gerrie Hiltz. Pass went a little long. Panetta will give it to Chris Flynn.
Greg, you get the feeling both teams are just taking a little bit of a breather. They've gone at just reckless pace for the first three quarters. I think they're just sucking back a little bit, knowing the last 10 minutes is going to be all you've got left.
Kind of like the 14th and 15th round of a championship boxing match. Here's Tucker. Tried to get it to Gabrielson, stolen away, I thought, by Tavares, but Gerrie reels it in to Tavares in midfield, a three-on-three opportunity. Tavares slows it down.
You see Buffalo work on this side of the goalie a lot because they have a tremendous amount of left-handed shooters.
Low shot by Tavares, gets by Metke, and this game is tied.
Tavares, the lefty, I talked about all the left-handed shooters. Hadley's a lefty, Veltman's a lefty, Tavares is a lefty. They start from that side to the goalie's left, to our right. They were looking for him to wheel it, maybe to shoot that way, but he backhanded this one and maybe took Metke by surprise. Again, they'll start from this side because they're really predominantly left. They'll come in for this left, move back once, behind, just a little behind the back, taking Metke by surprise. Again, starts from the left. They don't want to let him have his left hand, so they'll take it away from him. Watch how they'll set for his left hand, make him go back. He doesn't waste any time doing it, and rolls it in. A shot that you would think Metke would save. He's made all the dramatic ones. That one gets by him.
Flynn off the faceoff. This championship game at the Spectrum is tied 9 goals apiece.
And a hat trick so far by Tavares.
Miller sets it up. And I don't think he meant to do that.
Well, Alex,
leaves the field of play. Buffalo picks it up.
Spectrum in Philadelphia. We are tied at 9 with 11:47 to go in the game. The Bandits with the ball. Bringing in a very tough line. Darris Kilgour, Veltman, Emmett out there.
Save.
Keenan with a shot from the outside. Saved by Mickey McAvoy.
Keenan, one of the great scorers from Canada. Dave Emmett, the coach of Philly, coaches Keenan in the summer leagues.
Conley's shot goes high and into the stands for another souvenir. And Alexander trots down.
We were just looking at Gerrie, Craig, and he has gone a lot of minutes, second and third quarter combined. Got to be wearing them.
Replaced for a while by Cowie, but then went back into the net. All breaking.
With a goal-saving chip from behind, Miller just tailed the player, and when Hall shot, he got a little bit of wood on him.
Long pass, here's Mark Hahn, had work there. Hahn takes the shot himself. Gerrie out of the crease, gathers in the ball. And once he made sure that he had it, gave it to Milton.
A little bit of tentative play by both teams. Each goal is such a big goal now in the fourth quarter, and so much energy spent in the first three quarters.
Darris Kilgour. Looking to fire, moves in, takes the shot, Metke reels back, ball loose in the crease, and Metke pulls it in.
Again, that's not a Buffalo kind of shot. Kilgour comes in one-on-one, they don't move the ball, they've got to move the ball if they want to be successful. Right now, Philadelphia is dictating the defense and the offense for Buffalo by being very, very physical. They get into the net. Ground balls now, Philadelphia taking over there. They have really been impressive with their physical style, and it has rattled the normally passing-oriented offense of Buffalo.
Bissell with some very tough checks behind the crease on Gerrie Martin. 10 seconds on the shot clock as Chris Flynn has to hustle it down. They may do one of the dumps in the corner unless they get an opportunity to shot, and that one hit the post. See, I'm talking about all this, and he goes and does something like that.
Just got a chance for the big goal, and just hits the pipe.
Tavares with a juke move. He thought he had the goal.
Not much of an angle when he comes back with the left hand, but he did everything he could to try to beat Metke.
They are rumbling behind the crease.
Kilgour's the enforcer, number 35. He's in there. He might spend time in the box, but he's going to let Philadelphia know that this team can mix it up with the best of them.
Gerrie Martin called for the wings. Darris Kilgour, who led the Major Indoor Lacrosse League in penalties.
Well, Kilgour didn't waste any time walking over and getting comfortable in the box. There he is. And he'll be joined. It's going to be one for each. Martin goes over, and that's what made Philadelphia mad. Martin goes in the box, and they thought he didn't deserve it. Boy, almost knocked out two guys throwing a stick into the box first. Evans now trying to set up the 4-on-4. This allows the great offensive skills of some of these players like Tucker, like Tavares, to express themselves in the 4-on-4. Alexander getting ready to go on because now you've got 4-on-4, a lot more green out there, a lot more one-on-one where you can get clear to take the shot.
A pair of 5-minute penalties.
This is Flint's pipe shot just before the ball came down to the other end. Look at that. Beats the goalie, but doesn't beat the orange pipe. There'll be a face-off right there outside of the area where the penalty happened. There's apparently one for each team in the box. And Alexander now will take the face-off for Buffalo. Flynn for Philadelphia.
Off the face-off, Flynn wins it, holding the call against Alexander.
Alexander loses that face-off to Flynn very cleanly. He comes off the field, replaced by Veltman.
It's still 5-on-5 field players because of the offsetting major.
Absolutely. So both went in and they don't move the player on the surface.
Ball stolen away and here come the Bandits.
Well, Burns just picked that one out of the air. He's flagging up the passing lane. Nice alert intercepts.
Meridian trying to get it to Tavares. Tavares trying to get to the ball. Looked like he might have been held by Tucker there. Ball is still loose. Tavares picks it up, flips it up into the air. Meridian comes away with it with 5 on the 30. Out front to Alexander, who is nailed by Tucker. If Tucker's ribs are hurting, they may be his own hit.
Well, I think they exaggerate a little bit on his condition. If he had broken ribs, obviously he wouldn't be making hits like this. Tucker's all right. He got a little bit bruised in New York. No broken thing. No broken ribs. No cracked ribs even. This guy's a player. But Alexander has really been taking the bad side of a couple of those leveling blows.
McAvoy tried to feed it to Rash instead. Miller tries to put it in. Gerrie reels it in, looking for the long pass. Instead, he takes it to dump to Tavares. Mark Burnham brings it up. Mark Burnham, whose college roommate was a man by the name of Mike Rotunda, who was known as IRS in the World Wrestling Federation. Bet you didn't know that one.
And I'm not surprised you did. You are a wrestling dictionary.
Oh, let's not talk about that. Veltman with a shot.
Jay Recky.
Encyclopedia, I should say. Veltman again.
Veltman tries it again and does it. Veltman around the crease into the back of the net. And the Bandit fans, all three plus busloads of them, love that one.
Well, Jimmy Veltman doesn't have a lot of goals in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. He's known as a vacuum cleaner. He's got tremendous ground ball numbers. But he is a big-time scorer in Canada. And these are the skills that give him that reputation above the border. Look at this. Lunges himself out. Make the behind-the-back pass, much like Martin did for Philly early on. Slim one-goal lead. The very first lead for the Bandits.
7:53 to go. The Bandit fans are enjoying it now. We'll be back with more. The World Championship on Friday. There you get a good look at Veltman.
This is Chris Flynn for Philly and Gray, and you've got the veteran, Alexander, for the Bandits, facing off.
Gabrielson going after the ball. All day trying for it. And it's brought in by Brian Hall. Hall still has it. Hall looking for a man out front. Double team. He still has it. Takes it up for Tavares, who thought he had it. And a penalty will be called on John Tucker.
And he can't believe it. Great defense in front. The shot was there, but they're going to give him 2 minutes in the box, and Tucker just cannot believe it. Tremendous defensive play right out in front of the goalie. Metke was being swarmed on with offense. A lot of stingy stick work there. They didn't give it up. Hall didn't. He just wouldn't give it up. Tucker came in, wrapped him up. The way they've been calling this game, Craig, that is not a foul. It's pretty plain, I think, to our viewers at home. They've been letting a lot of things go. Tom Young was behind the play. This is what he called, and he's an excellent official. Bottom line is power play for the Bandits. And Craig, the last two times they had a power play, they notched a goal on each one.
There's Hamley out front. Sends it inside for Hall. The redirect is not successful. Alexander with a rebound.
Alexander is normally down where Hall is. Alexander would have had that ball, put it in. I don't know why he's high.
Hamley takes the shot deflected wide by Metke. Keenan on the rebound. His shot. Right to the sternum of Metke. 30 seconds gone in the power play.
Buffalo not pressing the situation here. They don't want to give Philadelphia an easy shot on their goalie. But Buffalo will mix it up. Normally Alexander's down there to take that shot, but he was high on the right-hand side that time.
John Conway inside for Billy Miller, who loses control of the ball. Fast break opportunity for the Buffalo Bandits.
This is where they got 5 goals on last time they played in Buffalo during the regular season.
Tavares back to the bench where Keenan will run the show.
They are so dangerous, Craig, on that counterpunch. They've got 55 seconds left in this power play. Hall still is going down low to the goal.
Hamley over to Keenan. Up top to Hamley. He fires it. Five on the shot clock. That will be a 30-second violation. And the officials finally whistle it, although
that ball is hit. Shot clock had expired. 30 seconds was up. They lose the ball, and it was very, very close.
There's no horn on the shot clock here, as there are in many arenas, so even if there was, it's so tough to hear with all the Spectrum fans.
Ricky Freed, the great player from Towson State.
Here's Matt Panetta. Excuse me, Miller dumping it in. Gerrie with a little jousting behind the crease. Veltman reels it in. Tavares takes it down, has Alexander by the net.
Tavares is a little bit tired. They have really done a good job, Philadelphia has. They went back behind the offensive line, back behind the midline, if they had it across the offensive zone, and that is loss of possession. But can you see, Craig, that Tavares is tired? They've really followed him up well.
Dedekin takes the shot. Gerrie sprawls Tucker out of the box now with a high shot.
Timely check by the Bandits to take that one high. Johnny Tucker looking like he's holding up pretty good in this very physical game, and some sore ribs from the New York contest to get them into this championship.
Tavares with 15 on the shot clock. Couldn't get the shot off. The stick check by Tucker takes it away. Ross Tucker team. Picks off the loose ball.
Greggy, double team, triple team. They're all over him. He's got to give the ball up. Go for some assists.
Veltman tries the stick check. Tucker over to Nostrand with a shot. McAvoy off the rebound. Tucker possibly looking. Takes it over to Nostrand on the right side. Nostrand with 10 on the shot clock. Played out of the way by Hall. This is Flynn. 6 on the shot clock. Flynn looks for the shot.
Pride of Philadelphia. Nobody has a bigger heart than Chris Flynn. Let's see how he gets this one. He just takes it out front. Too many shots at Gerrie. No defense on this. Flynn sees that he's got a little bit of a screen out here, and he'll just put some velocity on this right-handed shot and burn it past Gerrie.
We are tied at 10 as Chris Flynn, the hometown favorite, sends the fans wild in Philadelphia. And we'll be back.
Littering on the advertisements. They'll sell you the whole seat. You only need the edge. Well, a lot of the fans aren't even using their seats here at the Spectrum.
Shades of 89 and 90 for this Philadelphia Spectrum. This team is going to be tough to beat the last 4 minutes and 25 seconds. They've got a tie game and 16,000 people behind them.
The Buffalo Bandit fans who made the trip are going to try to help their team. I know the fans watching back in Buffalo are on the edge of their seat trying to root their team on trip.
Not a one-on-one on the offensive Buffalo, not their style. Philadelphia has forced them into something that is not quite comfortable for them.
This is Darris Kilgour going against John Tucker. Kilgour fires the shot, but it goes wide. Hiltz off the loose ball, dives through the crease, got the shot off.
Shot got down to zero, so they'll lose the ball.
The 30-second violation gives the ball to the Philadelphia Wings. 3 minutes, 48 seconds to go. Craig Johnson, Leif Elsmo, and a very loud spectrum.
This is it. The lump's in your throat now. You're going for the big ring. 3:30 left, and the next goal might do it.
Conley moving in. His shot goes high. Loose ball picked up by Darris Kilgour. And when was the last time you remember Buffalo being in a tight game?
It's been a while. They have won their winning streak of 10 games. Most games won by 9 goals. That's the average.
Here's Darris Kilgour. Jump shot deflected by Metke. Bissell fighting for the ball with Conley, a new 30-second clock. Out front, Alexander with the ball. He can do wonders with it here. Alexander trying to work through behind the back pass to Bissell. Picked up by Tavares. Tavares looking for the low shot. 14 on the shot clock. Alexander behind the crease fighting for the ball. As Metke sprawls. Whistle will blow as I believe they'll give it to Philadelphia for interference. 2:42 to go.
Whoa. Hands up off their seats right now. And Ricky Freed's line comes on with a chance to make history for this franchise. A world championship in the balance.
This is Chris Flynn. Flynn working against Burnham, sends it in front. The point blank shot taken by Ricky Freed. Panetta will fire, but that one blocked on the outside. 2:10 to go.
We're getting a lot of shots on Gerrie. Too many. The defense has to not only make the save, but get possession back. Philadelphia doing a great job of just maintaining control.
Gerrie Martin behind the crease. Flynn moving in. 10 on the shot clock. Flynn dumps it in the berth. Ball is loose in front. Martin with a point blank shot. It won't go. 2 seconds on the shot clock, and that will be a 30-second violation. The Bandits will get the ball with 1:45. You see it there on your screen.
And they're pushing the ball up. That's what they like to do.
Here's Jerry Hiltz with a shot. It goes wide to the right side. It's a one-on-one situation. Gabrielson. Stay Gerrie. And fans back in Buffalo are going, Gerrie, right about now.
And Veltman came in to just agitate him at the last moment. Veltman extended himself all the way down the field. Timeout called by Buffalo, 1:19, and they've got possession.
The sights and sounds of the Spectrum with 1:19 to go.
There's the big save. Gabrielson comes in. Look at Veltman. Comes over and just distracts him for a moment. He had to pull a stick in, I think, a moment earlier than maybe he would have wanted to. But a sensational save, no matter what. Gabrielson on the fast break, and Gerrie with the big-time save. Once again, the fast break. Metke outlets to Gabrielson. Veltman noticed it. Veltman comes in from the right. He's got an all-or-nothing saving check right here. Just misses the stick. But Metke, big-time save.
Bill Gerrie heading back towards the net. If there's no score, we go to a five-minute sudden death overtime. But both teams are not thinking about that here. They'd like to get a score in the last 1:19. Score, too. Let's just let you take a look at the North American Cup that awaits the winner.
Sitting there like nobody wants it. On the shadows there. That baby will be out in a moment on the presentation table. I guess it's a little bit too big, Greg, for somebody to stick in their pocket and take home.
1:19 to go here at the Spectrum in Philadelphia. The MILL World Championship on Prime Network. Craig Johnson and Leif Elsmo bringing it to you.
Now, Les Bartley just called a play. Let's see what he goes with. This is a championship chance. He's got his best play on the line.
9 on the shot clock as Tavares moves in. With 6 on the shot clock, he's tripped from behind, or he may have just tripped himself. 1 minute to go. Wings with the opportunity. Let's just let you look and listen. Tucker has it knocked away by Meridian. Gerrie reels it in.
With possession. Very tough call in the championship game. I think it was really, as loose as they've been calling it, pretty tough call for Scott to make, but he made it. The ball goes back to Philly. Now here's Dave Evans trying to get timeout. He's calling for a timeout. Nobody's watching him. Finally, he got their attention because there's a timeout right now. But Evans desperate to try to get his last play. Buffalo's didn't work. Philadelphia, with the arena behind them, a chance to win it all. There you go, Buffalo. Tough defensive assignment right here. Gerrie's going to get a shot. He knows that. This would win the North American Cup. 1992. Doesn't get any more pressure packed than this, Greg. 10-10, 34 seconds left. One game-winning shot by Buffalo that didn't work. Now Philadelphia with their chance.
The North American Cup awaits the winner of this game. 34.5 seconds to go in regulation. The Wings 10, the Bandits 10. And the ball belongs to the Philadelphia Wings. They've got Nostrand, Freed, Burt, Denikin, and John Tucker on the floor. Tucker will start it.
Well, Tucker's going to probably get it at the end of this, too. Watch for him rotating from behind.
Anakin. Shot taken by Muskrat, saved by Gerrie. Ball is loose, and with 19 seconds to go, the Bandits have an opportunity. This is Brian Hall bringing it down. Hall, running timeout, takes timeout. With 10 seconds to go.
Well,
it's hard to form a tee with those gloves on, holding a stick.
This is third match point. If it was tennis, it was Wimbledon. This is it. Buffalo had a chance to win it all. They didn't do it. Tough defense by Philly. Philly had a chance to do it all. Buffalo came up big on defense on their end. And now one more chance. That's Les Bartley to the left. Let's take a look at the last shot. This is Philadelphia's chance to win the championship this year. They still may get it, though. The save kept them from getting it with about 30 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. What a game for Gerrie. He's played just about the whole way. Meanwhile, Philadelphia has split time with Metcalf and Dallas Elliott. Les Bartley now calling the play. He's going to get the ball into the favorite person.
Spank on
see what he does.
Spank on the crease on the right crease.
Les Bartley, one of the coaches of the Bandits, calling the play. 10 seconds to go. We are tied at 10. Keenan will have the ball on the restart.
And Keenan hasn't done much tonight. I don't expect he'll take a shot. They are going to go ahead and get the ball up to one of the big boys.
Here we go. Saved by Metke.
That wasn't much of a play, was it? Keenan just came down in isolation. Time, folks.
Are you ready for overtime? If you're not, you better get ready, because it's next. Prime Network's coverage of the Major Indoor Lacrosse League World Championship continues from the Spectrum in overtime. The World Championship game at the Spectrum. Craig Johnson along with Leif Elsmo. There you see the championship banner. The fans here in Philadelphia would like nothing more than to see a 1992 added to that. 10-10. Alexander joined by Hall, Kilgour, Keenan, and Veltman to go against Chris Glenn, joined by Martin Rush, Tucker, and Freed. Overtime is underway. This is a sudden death overtime. First score will win it and take home the championship. This is Darris Kilgour. Kilgour fires the shot. It goes high. Keenan on the loose ball. 15 on the shot clock. Keenan moving in. Going against Resch. Keenan centers to Darris Kilgour. He spins but can't get the shot off. Martin reels it in for the wings.
They had a great chance for a shot there. Kilgour waiting too long, and of course that aggressive defense by Philadelphia, they don't give you any time.
Paul Denikin will take it back to John Tucker.
Well,
the pass deflected.
The Philadelphia Wings win this. I think it's almost assured that Tucker is going to be involved in the winning score.
We have played 1 minute of overtime. First one that scores wins, no matter how long it takes. This is John Tavares. To Jerry Hiltz, around the pick by Tavares. Hiltz fires the shot, kick save by Metke. John Nostrand bringing it up.
Kilgour to pull back though and not shoot when he didn't have one.
Tavares right in front, played off the ball. He gets the ball back behind the back. Shot goes in. The Buffalo Bandits have won the championship.
And the league scored. John Tavares came up with the big one.
teams. Philadelphia gave it everything they had, led by John Tucker. And Tavares, 4 goals on the night. We talked about how he was probably the best player on this field. I think he proved it tonight.
Let's take a look at it again.
Bounced around here. Nobody gets the shot. Tavares can't get free, but he sticks with it. Gets his own follow-up, and then behind the back is what really got the ball past Petke. Otherwise, that ball doesn't go in. Sensational sense by Tavares to know when to shoot that wraparound shot. Here he is again. He'll get the ball from behind right here. He gets knocked off by Miller. So the ball's loose. He'll pick it back up, and what really takes the play by Conley is that it goes behind his back. Conley had it marked for the left-handed shot. Tavares takes control of the game. 4 goals on the night.
Fans in Buffalo will be watching this replay for a long, long time.
They have made history, Craig, going from an expansion franchise, losing 3 games, and winning the championship.
We're going to have the presentation of the North American Cup. It'll go to the Buffalo Bandits. 5 seconds into overtime. And John Tavares scores a goal that gives the Buffalo Bandits the 1992 version of the MILL World Championship. One more look at the winning goal, and fans back in Buffalo are jumping up and down right here. John Tavares with a goal, and to the victors go the rewards. Here's Chris Fritz and Russ Klein of the MILL.
But this team, the Buffalo Bandits, deserve an incredible hand for a great season they've come on with. It gives me great pleasure to present them with the North American Cup. Johnny Meridian is taking his Bandits all the way in his first year, along with Coach McGeady and Les Bartley. And come here. Gives me great pleasure to give you this. You well deserve it.
We'd just like to take a second to thank all the Buffalo fans that drove eight hours to be here. And also thank the Wings for probably one of the best lacrosse games ever. Let's hear it for the Wings, guys. Thank you very much.
Thanks again, guys. Take that trophy.
Ladies and gentlemen,
you got it. Thanks again, guys. Take that trophy.
Ladies and gentlemen,
you got it, yeah.
A spectrum hand for a job well done for the Buffalo Bandits. Let's show our class, ladies and gentlemen. Buffalo, the world champs.
MILL World Championship. Leif Elsmo will be talking to some of the victors, but right now you take a look at some of the busloads of fans that have driven over 8 hours to come down to the Spectrum in Philadelphia. The Bandits, an expansion team, as the Major Indoor Lacrosse League season began. And you heard at the beginning of the program, Buff McCready, he had some very prophetic words. But now with some words, our Coors Light MVP standing by with Leif Elsmo. Leif?
Well, Greg,
Thank you very much. Our Coors Light MVP is John Tavares. 4 goals. John, your numbers are sensational. We've talked before when you have been the Coors Light MVP. Not only do you score, but you get assists, and you play for the ground balls. You play the full field. He came up big tonight when your team needed you.
Well, this game's a whole team effort. Defense, offense, you got to play both ways. You're only one player. You've got weakness. You got to play both ways.
I still think that Philadelphia kept you out of your offense the whole 4 quarters, and you were lucky to get out of here alive.
You're right. Lacrosse is a game of transition. They got back in the hole. They set up on defense. They took away our fast breaks. I mean, a good goaltending makes us take bad shots.
How about Metke coming in there in the second half? Did he throw some different problems at you?
Actually, I played with him in the summer. He was actually my goalie in Vancouver. And that last goal there, I think he thought I was going to pass it off. And that's why I shot it over the shoulder. I normally don't do that. But
talk us through that last goal from when you got the ball and it was literally checked back to the floor.
I got the ball and Darris Kilgour was on the crease. And I looked at him and I knew Dwight saw me look at him. So I threw it over my shoulder and I think I caught him off guard.
Tremendous year for you guys. Could you ever imagine when you were 0-3 that you'd be here right now?
Not really. We got off to a very slow start. We're fortunate to be here.
Well, tremendous year. Our congratulations again to you, John. And now we'll go back up to Craig for some more comments on our post-game show.
From 0-3 to the Major Indoor Lacrosse League Championship, the story of the 1992 Buffalo Bandits. We'll tell more of that story when we return to the Spectrum in Philadelphia. 11-10, Bandits the overtime winner. Time to take a look.